Hello everyone, welcome to Mini Apple. I am 小银照。In this video, we will be talking about the characteristics of video content, which influence the degree of its contagion, through comparing two different YouTube videos produced by myself.
Drawing on Berger's 2013 steps framework, I will argue that the videos which emphasize arousing emotions such as anger and hope and had a broad target audience are more contagious than videos which focused on practical value and had a more limited target audience. Within the time available, the video which generated the greatest user engagement proportion of total views was Media Society, in which the strongest characteristics was stories and emotion. Within the time available, the video within my portfolio, which generated the lowest levels of user engagement proportion of total views, was Media and Geek, which focused on practical value for a specific audience. Since Media Geek video was released earlier than Media Society video, it got more user engagements. In fact, the Media Geek video user engagement proportion of total views is lower than Media Society. One is 10.22% and another is 14%. Researchers studying Twitter have found that content that resonates with users is more likely to grow into a viral trending topic than content does not. Thus, I picked up the topics, the influence of social media, which are related with our life increasingly, for the Media Society video. My Media Society video focuses on negative influence from social media today. The video tells the story of one person who posts all her life on social media, Instagram, which takes her much time to expect others' attention. In this video, I focused on telling the story of one individual at a normal day in her life. As Berger said, just like the epic tale of the Trojan horse, stories are vessels that carry things such as morals and lessons. Information travels under the guise of what seems like idle chatter. I want to guide people to think about the life controlled by social media through exhibiting a normal life of a normal person. Stories are easier for viewers to understand and they may find some similarities in themselves. Since it is so close with people's life, audiences are easier to remember it and share with other people, which would increase the wider discussion or more amount of view. The video has a call to action and it asks viewers to reflect the influences of social media addiction on our life and find the correct way of using them. In promoting this video, my main target audience was all the people using social media, especially teenagers and young adults who spend much time on social media.
When you repeat compulsive internet behavior, despite the negative consequences in your offline life, you may have a serious problem, often referred to as social media addiction.
To reach this audience, I asked my friends, classmates, and the followers in different social media to share my video. For 6 days, although this video only achieved 50 views, 6 likes, 1 shares, the user engagement proportion of total views is 14%. It is believed that the number of engagements would increase with the increased number of views. Analysis of YouTube metrics show that the majority of viewers are drawn from UK, with a smaller number of viewers drawn from Hungary and China. The majority of viewers was a female with a smaller number of males. The majority of viewers were aged 18 to 24, with a smaller number of viewers aged 25 to 34. This is result fits the target audiences of mine, teenagers and young adults who spend more time on social media. To promote my video, I think I could ask the bloggers who had more followers and great impact to focus on this social problem and share my video.
So I'm here for two reasons. I want to deliver two messages. The first message I want to deliver is that even though I've never had a social media account, I'm okay.
To conclude this section, within the time available, the the video which generated the greatest user engagement proportion of total views in terms of views, likes, shares, and comments was Media Society, which most strongly demonstrated the contagious characteristics of stories and emotion, and which have a very broad target audience. By contrast, my Media Geek video promoted much lower levels of user engagements of total views.
My Media Geek video focuses on the renaissance of Hollywood. The video introduced a social background containing political and economic reasons as the classic movies at that time as their similar characteristics. The video has three calls to action. Firstly, it reminds audience that movies in a specific period could be influenced by the specific historical background, and people could think about the spirit of movies after watching. Secondly, the video asks the viewers to like the video, and thirdly, to subscribe to the channel. This has a commercial goal of increasing the likelihood of greater user engagement in future videos and enhancing the channel's appeal to advertisers. In promoting this video, my main target audience was those people who are interested in movies or its history, as well as the students of film studies. To reach this audience, I asked my classmates and friends to share my video. In addition, according to Revkant and Rifkin, Twitter is essentially one large interest network organized around topics of interest more than social connection. People who are interested in the topic of video or mine may share this link more easily, so I asked a video essay blogger on movies to share my video. For 15 days, this video achieved 176 views, 12 likes, 1 shares, 2 user comments, and 3 subscriptions to the channel. The user engagement proportion of total views is 10.22%. Analysis of YouTube metrics showed that the majority of viewers were drawn from UK, with a smaller number of viewers drawn from Iceland and China, and the majority of viewers were female, with a smaller number of males. The majority of viewers were aged 18 to 24, with a smaller number of viewers aged 25 to 34. This result was caused by the content of the video, which focused on the practical value and professional knowledge, lacked the attraction for those people who are not interested in this. To promote my video, I think I could ask the bloggers who had more followers and greater impacts of the era to share my video.
The study of technical things, and the reason I teach it is that it belongs to everyone, that it's valuable for everyone. Not everyone needs to know about quantum mechanics, but I believe everyone should, and if they don't, I feel they're impoverished, know how to read a good story, enjoy plays, know how to enjoy the movies.
To conclude this section, within the time available, the video which generated the lowest user engagement proportion of total views, in terms of views, likes, shares, and comments, was Media Geek, which most demonstrated the contagious characteristics of practical value and had a very limited target audience. From this analysis, I conclude that it is important for a viral video to have a broad target audience, and a story with a good narration and resonance which could arouse audience's emotion could bring more user engagements. That's all from me for now. If you enjoyed this video, please click like and subscribe below, leave your comment, and check out our other videos. This has been me, Xiaoyun Zhao for Media Report. Thanks for watching.